life of holiness means you enter into the desire of the Father, the will of the Father, and you always live in the presence of the Father, where the enemy doesn't come near you. That's why in the book of Isaiah chapter 35 verse 8 it is written, a highway, not an ordinary way. Do you want to travel in a highway, all thing fast, fast? You want to do many things in your life fast, fast? There is one way, he says. A highway shall be there, and a road, and it shall be called the highway of holiness. The highway of holiness, where you will never be attacked by anybody. Yes, I'll read for you a small passage. You understand this, then we will go ahead. Those of the Bible, you can take Isaiah chapter 37 verse 1 to 7. And so it was when King Ezekiah heard it that he tore his clothes, covered himself with sackcloth, and went into the house of the Lord. Then he sent Eliakim, who was over the household, Shebana the scribe, and the elders of the priests, covered with the sackcloth, to Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amos. And they said to him, thus says Hezekiah, this day is the day of trouble and rebuke and blasphemy, for the children have come to birth, but there is no strength to bring them forth. It may be that the Lord our God will hear the words of Rabshakeh, whom his master the king of Assyria has sent to reproach the living God, and will rebuke the words which the Lord your God has heard. Therefore, lift up your prayers for the remnant that is left. So the servants of King Hezekiah came to Isaiah, and Isaiah said to them, thus you shall say to your master, thus says the Lord, do not be worried or afraid of the words which you have heard, with which the servants of the king of Assyria have blasphemed me. Surely I will send a spirit upon him, and he shall hear the rumor and return to his own land, and I will cause him to fall by the sword in his own land. I don't know how many of you, some of you may not know the background, so you may not understand fully. I explain to you. Hezekiah is a servant of God. God did many, many great things in his life. But Hezekiah was not a man of awareness. He was sick. He was almost dying. And he cried to God. God healed him. God said to Hezekiah 5 things. Number 1, your God hears your prayer. Number 2, God has seen your tears. Number 3, God is telling you will not die now. Number 4, he has added 15 more years to you. Number 5, you are looking towards Jerusalem. Within 2 to 3 days, you will get up and go to Jerusalem. What an instant deliverance. He is dying with the cancer. And the Lord said to Isaiah to go and bring some fig fruits, and he put it on his over. That's all. The man caught up. The enemy comes in the form of sickness, and Ezekiel is crying. God delivered him. But having delivered, God now tells him, the evil people are around you. Having delivered, you should deliver your people from all the bondages. And that is possible if you remain holy. If you are defiled, the enemy will come and defile you. That's what evil did to Daniel in Daniel chapter 1 verse 8. In order to, now Daniel is going to be a mighty weapon in Babylon among the enemies. How? Through the life of holiness. Life of holiness means, again I repeat, be moving around the presence of God. Take care of yourself, that my whole life, my thoughts, my emotions moves around the presence of God, moves around the will of God, where the enemy has no space to enter in. It is there the enemy cannot touch me. And that's what Daniel also did, like Hezekiah, which Hezekiah did not learn. Daniel, he learned. So the enemy is coming in a very good form. They are coming in the form of the man who is in charge of him. Look, you are supposed to eat the chicken, mutton, beef, all that is given for you. Different style. Chicken 64, 694, all that. It is kept for you. And then look, these drinks, beer, whiskey, rum, this is from US, this is from America, this from this company, I don't know the name of the companies. So different variety, all this available for you, and you are to eat nicely and be grateful to the king. All rosy, rosy, rosy. Inside, you drink all that, stop praying. Drink all that. Once you begin to drink, as the book of Proverbs chapter 23 says, your mind will be lost. If you drink, what will happen? We'll go through that also, because that is also important these days, for so many people are going through that kind of struggle. So we'll go through that also. Once chapter 23 we read, who has woe? Verse 29 onwards, who has sorrow, who has contention, who has complaint, who has wounds without cause, who has redness of eyes, those who linger long at the wine, those who go in search of mixed wine, do not look on the wine when it is red, when it sparkles in the cup, when it swirls around smoothly, and at last it will bite you like a serpent, and it will sting like a viper. Your eyes will see strange things, and your heart will speak perverse things. Yes, you will be like the one who lies down in the midst of the sea, or like the one who lies at the top of the mast, saying, they have struck me, but I have not hurt. They have beaten me, but I did not feel it. When shall I get up and go have another drink? How? Through the drinks, the enemy defiles the body and enters into that man and destroys his whole life. In another place it is written, the man who drinks destroys his own generation. Yes. How? Through drinks, through unholy, first make the man unholy, and then he destroys that man.